Hi, everyone. Once again, News 8 on your side, helping you with your money. And once again today, we're joined by Tim Decker, the president of ISI Financial. Want to talk to you about a hot topic, Social Security benefits. When should I take them? When should I not? A lot of people talk about age 62, the good and bad of age 62.
Okay. 62 is the earliest that you can take it. Unfortunately, that is the most common age that people do take it. Mm-hmm. It can make sense at that age if indeed you and your spouse are in poor health, because typically and generally the break-even point of when it makes sense to wait is roughly about age 80. So it can make sense in that case. And then obviously if you're in a spot where you need the money, then that's obvious.
So age 65, most people, that's the age that we hear most often. What's the pro and con there?
Yeah, actually full retirement age is 66, and for some now it's actually 67. At that age, you will receive 25% more than what you would have had you taken it at 62.
And you have to take it by the time you get to age 70, correct?
You don't have to.
Oh, you don't have to, okay.
But you will not continue to accrue benefits.
What is the number one thing that determines the benefit amount?
Well, it's not just one.
Okay.
It has to do with your age. It has to do with your working, your earnings history. And typically, it's based on your highest 35 years of earnings history.
Okay, and I have to ask you this question.
Sure.
Just how secure is Social Security's future?
Right, right. I say it's secure. Now, as it stands now, come 2035, if something has not changed, it's estimated that we're gonna have a reduction of about 25% in benefits, but something's gotta change.
And that's gonna make a little,
yeah. It's
gonna make a lot of people angry,
yeah,
wouldn't it?
Right. Yeah.
Tim Decker, thank you very much. I'm Brian Roach, on your side, News 8.